Hey, what it is, what it do, it's your boy Powerhouse, and this is Eagles Powerhouse Nation, and we got a lot of Eagles business to discuss. But before we get into the nitty gritty, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you could get all of the latest and greatest stuff that I put out there. And let's get right down to the topic of conversation, which is, what is going on with some of these contracts? It's only really one in particular that I have an issue with, and you already know who's responsible. His first name start with an H, last name is a R. And he kind of is HR for the Eagles, but he needs to be fired. Howie Roseman put together some interesting contracts. One in particular, very bad one, and we talking about the Joe Flaccos contract. Now, the Joe Flaccos contract, as everybody know, unless you live under a rock, Joe Flaccos is the backup. And you would think that a backup, especially on Joe Flaccos' caliber, would get a backup type of deal, especially since he's not the starter. I mean, as much as everybody want to try to talk about how, oh, he could be the starter, he's not. It's Jalen Hurts. But, so, his contract is $3.5 million guaranteed this year. Could make up to $7.5 million. $7.5 million for a backup. And last year, the funny thing is, he didn't even make $2 million. It was a little bit over $1 million last year that he had made with the Jets. And he went 0-4, which is why he's not on the Jets anymore. So my question is, what was going through the mind of the Eagles front office and Howie Roseman to give Flacco that deal? I'm trying to understand. I mean, he's not worth that. I'll tell you this right now. He's not worth that. Now, people are saying that, like, oh, well, he came off of an injury when he was going to, when he went to the Jets. And that's why they gave him such a low deal. That's what the article has said. Okay, I mean, what I would say to that is, look at what he did before that. He ain't really do much before that. Like, he got an injury, and okay, he got worse. But he wasn't all that good to begin with before the injury. Now, I'm not talking about the young Flacco, went to the Super Bowl Flacco. So, all the people that's going to end up trying to get on me for that, no. Not talking about that. I'm talking about right now, Flacco, past 2 years, he is not a $7 million quarterback at all. So, and the thing is, the way that it's structured, he's supposed to get $1.5 million this year and $2 million next year. Who knows if he even going to be here next year? But the thing is, if you cut him next year, you still got a $2 million dead money hit on a quarterback that shouldn't have even got that much guaranteed money in the first place. Beyond me, but next person is Brandon Brooks that I'm thinking of. And by the way, these were ranked as top three. I'm only going to go over two. The other one is obvious. They talking about Carson Wentz. I'm not going to talk about him. He's not an Eagle. Unless I need to. In this situation, I don't. But the second contract is Brandon Brooks. And you can kind of put Lane Johnson in this too, because pretty much they in the same boat. But Brandon Brooks in particular, he's making the second most out of any offensive guard in football. And I forget who the person was who's over him. Sheriff or something like that is number one. But Brandon Brooks his original contract was about $14 million a year. That's a lot. Now, he played to that contract. That's why I don't have a problem with this one. Is because he played to that contract. he earned that contract. He just ended up all of a sudden getting all these injuries out of nowhere. And I look at it like this. If he ends up playing back to the way that he was before, I have no problem with the contract. The only thing is, that's a big contract. Like, now what they did was they rescheduled it or restructured it to $7 million for this year. But then it's going to be over $19 million next year. The year after that, over $18 million. The year after that, over $19 million again. So he has to end up playing back to where he was in order to justify all that money. And the bad part about it is we can't cut him because that's going to be a huge dead money hit if we did, and he doesn't play up to that. So we kind of stuck with Brandon Brooks. But that's a good problem to have as far as he's been playing, as far as I'm concerned. That's why I'm not too concerned about that contract. Lane Johnson, same thing. That's why I said he is one of the top people paid in the draft and in the NFL at his position. But again, if he plays like he was when he earned it, I have no problem with it. But the Flacco thing, But let me know what you think in the comment section. Should Flacco be earning that much money? Pretty much. Now, if you say yes, please give me a reason why he deserves that much money. But with that being said, make sure you like, comment, subscribe. And hey, I'll see you.